Hi, I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on saving and loading databases into the System Manager using the RMT tool. We're going to be covering the use of the RMT tool, Remote Management Tool, for the purpose of saving a database and loading the database. For familiarity purposes, everything that's sitting on this side of the screen are simulators that you can use if you're actually opening up an offline program. And on the left side over here would be databases that have previously been saved. Now, in order for me to be able to save a database from a controller, I first have to log into that controller. So I go up here in the top where the login option is. It has to know, or you have to know, the IP address of that unit. The web port is 80, that's our default, but it could possibly be changed. So you would have to make sure you had the correct IP address, you have to have the correct port, and then on its own, it goes out and locates the controller and says, well, your username and password are required. If I have default standards from Danfoss, it is going to be supervisor, and the password will be 12345. It accepted my login. You can see up here, it wants me now the option to log out. You can also see welcome me logging in as supervisor. And there is the IP address that I use. So now that I know I'm logged into that particular controller, and just for the purpose of clarification, if I have multiple controllers at any given site, I have to log into each one individually in order to do a saving or reloading of the actual database, which means I'd have to log out and now log into the next controller and on down the line. So once I'm logged in, I will go up here to the Tools option, and I'm going to go to Controller Database Manager. This, you can see, still has the same IP address, the same web port, and it's telling us the version of the controller. Here is where we make the selection of whether we're saving a database or whether we're going to reload a database that I had previously saved. So I'm going to go to save, I'm going to go to the connect option, and the green check marks here tell me that the hardware is good, tells me that the device status is good, and the factory failsafe is all good as well. So the three green check marks tells us go ahead and proceed. Anything other than green check marks, you probably want to go back and evaluate and make sure that what you have is correct. This is the next screen, which now says where we're going to be saving the information on our computer. I have the option to go to save to, so I can select any location on my computer. On mine, I'm going to the C drive, and it's going specifically to my system database program, or folder, I should say. And then I can go and give it a name. So you can see the name is S55. That is the default extension that we use. The term latest was put in there, and that's just the default. I am restricted to 8 characters underneath this. So I possibly want to do, my chain is ABC, possibly underscore, I'm unit 33, and then I am unit 0. So my chain is ABC, my store is 33, and I'm working on unit 0. Now I can get down here and go into much greater detail. So again, ABC. Store 33, unit 0, and any format that you choose to select to keep yourself organized in your file structure. But just remember, this up here has to be no more than 8 characters. And once I have that in place, I just simply say start, and it will now take off and with a status bar tell us our progress that we're making. Once it finishes, it gives us the green check mark saying that we have just completed our saving of the database. And I say done, and I now have a copy of that sitting over here on this side right here. You see abc.s55, so always the S55 extension, and that is the program that I just saved. On the other side now, if I wanted to reload that program, I would do the same process. Remember, I'm already logged in. I'm going to go to Controller Database Manager. Instead of saving the database, I'm going to do load the database. Same check marks are shown to us. We proceed, and now the program is saying, where is the program residing that you want to load in? I go up here, I'm going to find this program. You can see that it knows where I've been saving them. Here's the ABC unit zero. I now have that one selected and I can start to download. Now, as you notice, it gives us a disclaimer, remotely upgrading a system database does carry a risk of failure. That's always a possibility. So it's just a disclaimer saying that is possible. And we begin the process, which is going to be now loading that database in. It just sent the database down to the controller in a staging area. And then as soon as it gets down there complete, it resets the controller. So it's been downloaded, but we're in the process of resetting the controller. And you can see the status circle taking place here. And it has to be understood that this is some time, this will take some time for the unit to come back up and to reconnect and to send me the update. So you do have to realize that you could be up to about 2 minutes of time for the controller to actually go through the reset, to reboot, and then to come back online and report back to us. So we will sit here and just wait for that to end. And when it does, a green check mark will come up and it'll give us updated information as to what the database is that we inserted in the controller. We see we have the green check mark, which indicates that we have completed the download. The unit has reset, it has come back up, and when it did, it came back up in this format right here with this file name, this description. So that means we have now just reloaded the database in that controller and it's back in operation. So with this being done, we can say done, and we are completed with that particular unit. So I would go up here and log out. And again, if I had other units there that I wanted to either save the database or load the database, I would go up to log in and put in there that IP's information for that particular unit, and it would be in operation to do anything with the controller. As you notice here, it's grayed out. It is because I am not logged in. And this concludes the session on using the RMT for saving and loading databases. For more information on this topic, see the description below. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.